time, with somebody like me, anyway, they'll sit in the booth and they'll tweak my voice a little bit until they get what they want out of me, and then they'll say, okay, commit that one to memory. Then we'll have something called voice ref, and they save that, and
next time we come back,
they play it right off. Yeah.
Then we have to, they'll play it for us so we know what our character was before we start the session. They always play the character that they take with us so we know the zone is.
That's it, exactly. Yeah.
And sometimes in a, like, even though Cyber Six looked like was an anime kind of thing, it's actually recording with a different process, which was the prelay process, we call it, versus the ADR process, which is typical MMA. So typical MMA is that we have a TV screen in front of us. The original show was recorded in Japan, and then we're lip syncing with beeps in our headphones. So we go beep, 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 and on the fourth beep, we deliver our line, by line, by line. So we're not in a group. We're individuals going in just doing our role. That's typical for MMA. Cyber Six was done in a prelay format, which meant we had like 5 to 9 actors standing in a half circle with everyone having a music stand and their sets and stuff, and a director with a script, so there's nothing to look at. It was drawn after. And that was unusual because that doesn't normally happen in
any. It's way more complex than I think I expected when I started out. I thought, oh yeah, this is going to be. It's going to be a cinch, and I was a stage actor, and so I thought, I'm not even going to have to memorize these lines. I get on my tray, I can just read it off, and I can look at all my notes. I don't have to worry about any of my action, but then you get into the studio and you realize, oh shoot, I haven't memorized any of my lines, but so you read it and you memorize it just as you're reading it, you just memorize it at one point. And you're trying to watch what mood your character's in, and you're trying to get that feeling, and at the same time you've got James in your headset or one of the other directors saying, okay, in this case, you're really, really angry, you're really angry. And then as he's saying that, you'll hear like, beep, 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 where that fourth beep would be, that's where you open your mouth.
There's this higher character that you just did.
Yeah, that's why.
Okay, go on.
I do have a range, see? I can do other characters. Where that fourth beat, that's how you know, that's where your character first opens their mouth, and so you're watching for that, and then you deliver your line, and you're trying not only to do it effectively, but trying to match the flaps, as we call it, and then at the end, James will be like, oh, I think you lost kind of the feeling that we were working for, and so then you go back and do it again.
And it's hard to sort of, get into the, it's a different process to work like in ADR than it is to do, just means you're doing it line by line, than it is to work in a group of actors, because then you can listen to each other and play off each other. You have to react by listening, as opposed to when you're a TV actor, you're looking at each other and there's all this physical, visual stuff, right? But you have to imagine it in your mind when you're reacting in cartoons, because there's no memorizing, you have to look at your script, there's no one to react off. So you have to hear it and then get the reaction from that.
Yeah.
But sustaining the voice and sustaining the character is like a big deal. I mean, I there's a new show I can't talk about, but it's as cute as a bug's ear. It's like a Hamtaro thing, but it's really freaking cute. Like, I couldn't stand the view. This was painful. Anyway, I have this very strange little character. They're all cute. They're like, you wait for it. I can't tell you about it, but anyways, it's so cute. And I guess I can do the voice because you won't know what I'm talking about. But anyway, it's sort of,
oh, everybody, oh, I don't know if we can do this. Oh, no, I'm so frightened. Oh.
This sort of thing. And when he falls asleep, he goes, oh. the little things flutter up, So I can tell you about it. But, you do a character like that, and you're doing that for a 4-hour call, and that's a great way.